Hello, welcome back. In this video, we'll discuss what is a multi-track Turing machine and how we can equate a multi-track Turing machine with that of your normal single-tape Turing machine, single-track Turing machine. Okay, so in general, we usually have a single-track Turing machine like this. We have a single tape, single track. Each cell is capable of storing one input at a time, and usually we have a single finite control with a single read rate head that is capable of reading this transition. Whatever is the content of the tape, it can read at a time, and based on that, it may take a transition. Whereas a multi-track Turing machine is one where in a single tape, this is divided into tracks. Okay, and each cell of the track is capable of storing one input element at a time. Okay, so the transition over here is, again, you are going to have a single finite control and single read-write head over here. So here the transition function is written as transition of a state on a set of inputs. Okay, it read all the tracks at a time, and based on that it make a transition. Okay, from this state to Q1 it can have a transition, and this track can be replaced with some other element. Okay, so this is also allowed, and then it can make a left side move or right side move. The process is again same as that of your Turing machine. Okay, so this is a multi-track Turing machine. In a single tape, it is split into multiple tracks, and each cell is capable of storing one input element at a time. Whereas what happened with our normal single tape Turing machine, we have a single tape and each cell is capable of storing one input element at a time, and based on the current state and current input symbol, we make a transition. So that is how a normal Turing machine works. Okay, even though you have a multiple tracks in a multi-track Turing machine, it is equivalent to that of a single track Turing machine. That actually means that for any problem, if you can design a single tape Turing machine, you can again convert that to a multi-track. And if you can design a multi-track Turing machine, you can again convert this to a single track Turing machine. Like, while looking at it, we can say that this multi-track Turing machine seems to be more powerful than a single track Turing machine. But the thing is, this is equivalent. Okay, it is equivalent. It means that if you can design a single track Turing machine, then surely multi-track exists. And multi-track, if you can solve a problem using multi-track Turing machine, you can solve that using a single, you can simulate that again using a single track Turing machine. Okay, so to prove that it is equivalent, one way is like here each cell is capable of storing one input element at a time, right? So instead of having your input as a single A or a single B, we can have it as A, B, C, all the combination of your input. So based on the number of tracks you have for this Turing machine, if you want to simulate this Turing machine in a single tape Turing machine, the input element will be of this structure. Okay, so this is considered to be a single element. Okay, so you can modify this as A, B, C as one input, and second configuration like this. This will be your third input, and all the blank symbol, this will be your normal input. Okay, so here the input symbols are not just A, B, C. It is the combination of it. You have A, B, C, A, A, B, all the combination of A, B, C's. Whatever, like if my input is made up of A, B, C, all the tracks it might have either A or B or C or blank symbol. So all the combinations work out over here. And the transition here can be written as from a state on an input symbol. It might be any of this combination. It might be A, B, C or some other combination. We can have a transition to some other state if it is from Q0 to Q1. And if this is the configuration needed, I can write it as BBB. Okay, so this denotes that it is simulated, right? Like a multi-track Turing machine is simulated using a single-track Turing machine when you modify the input elements alone. Okay, so this actually says that it is all equivalent. Okay, it is not more powerful. It is equivalent. If you can design a multi-track Turing machine for any problem, then surely that can be simulated using a single-track Turing machine. So it is equivalent. Okay, thank you.